first 3D printed prosthetics conference held here at Johns Hopkins. Together with Enabling the Future and Jon Schull, we have brought together for the first time family members, prosthetists, engineers, physicians, all for the purpose of not only delivering 25 hands for children in need, but also for the meeting of the minds of the medical and printing community.
And what we did is we brought together our community of 3D printing enthusiasts who have been making prosthetic limbs at historically low costs, like free. We brought them together with professional prosthetists who have been making very high-end, medically sound, but inaccessible to many people, prostheses.
Then you're going to look for two long pins, two long snap pins. They look like this.
We had a room full of practitioners learning how to make 3D prosthetic limbs.
We're learning right now how to actually put together a hand, which is really neat. There's a lot more that goes into it than you might actually think. We've been working with RIT since July on creating an arm-hand combination for her to use. And we just thought, when we received the invite, we were very excited, and we thought it would be a great opportunity to meet other families and other children that have differences similar to Lucy's and learn more about the different technologies.
Things that I've learned is the different methods you can use to print things. So speed, the volume of plastic that you have coming out of the nozzle at one time and how it affects the print.
How the cooling can affect how it comes out and whether you want something solid or what type of infill density you want, how heavy or light it can be is something that I think it's really cool that a lot of people don't necessarily think of at first how intricate they can get into it, but it really does get technical.
I have to tell you, I really think with the open source software that is available for these 3D prints and the brilliant minds and individuals that are involved in this, we are seeing an exponential growth in the complexity of designs, and really there'll be a crossroads between traditional prosthetics and 3D printed prosthetics where there'll be a point where we won't be able to tell the difference between the two.
Here we go. Okay, one last round of applause for the cyber superhero.